Hello everyone and welcome or welcome back to the channel. In this video we'll be covering horses of RDO world. Now you'll get your first horse in the mission Honor Amongst Horse Thieves from Clay Davis, a familiar face from the story mode. Now, of course, as you already knew, Clay Davis is all about rustling horses, so he will instruct you to steal a horse for him, and it will be a Kentucky Saddler. Now, I guess the honor part is where he allows you to keep the horse you have stolen already, but hey, that's a gift, so take it and enjoy your ride until you get better horse. Now, I've already mentioned dozens of times that people who bought Ultimate Edition have serious advantage. The same goes for horses. You will have a pretty nice horse for free, and it's the same thoroughbred, black chestnut thoroughbred you got in the story mode as well. But the real question here is which horse to take when you start your RDO journey, if not these two horses, of course. Now, these basic horses are all equally bad, in all honesty, and if I would have to decide, I would splash my money on this red chestnut Arabian. Now, all Arabians are considered to be superior horses, in the superior horses class, of course, and they are actually the only horses considered to be superior. Why, in all honesty, I don't know. But I do know that there is significant difference between red chestnut, white and black Arabian. While this red chestnut is really an entry level horse, it still has superior handling, but in all honesty you will not notice the difference between this and standard handling, which you will find in all these multi-class horses as this Missouri Foxtrotters. Now, since we already entered the multi-class horses, you will find the best horses in this group. Missouri Foxtrotters, Turkomans, Mustangs, and all roan horses are listed in multi-categories, so you will definitely find your horse here. And if you save just 500 bucks or even get a coupon with discount, probably 30% discount, you will find your horse for 350 bucks, which is measly price for such a good horse like Mustang. Now, there is a catch, of course. You will not buy first three listed Mustangs in the Mustang list. Only those four horses added in December of 2020 are worth your money and time. And the good thing regarding all those horses added in December of 2020 is they are not level restricted, so you will be able to buy them as soon as you get your money, of course. And now we get to the roan horses. Bretons are the first horses we will talk about, and they are bounty hunters horses. If you bought Ultimate Edition, guess what, you will be able to have one for free. But in all honesty, it's pretty bad horse, it's basic Breton, so take it if you want, but it will occupy your slot without a reason. By slot I'm meaning the horse stall in the stable. Besides Bretons, you have Criollos, Quadrubers, Norfolk Roadsters and Gypsy Cobs as roan horses. And if you buy any of these horses, you should buy only those unlocked when you reach established level in your roll. Because all those unlocked before established level are not worth your time and money, of course. And if you ask yourselves, is there a difference between these horses? Yeah, there is. The best among them, stats-wise, are Norfolk Roadsters. Stats-wise, of course, if we are talking about speed and acceleration. But if you're kind of a cowboy that cares more for stamina and health bar, well, the best are Gypsy Cobs and Bretons. But considering their price, and when you compare them with Mustangs, those four I've already mentioned are added in December of 2020, there is no too much difference, but there is a significant difference in price. In all honesty, those Mustangs are equally good as Bretons, which cost 950 bucks. And if you care for that one extra health bar, well, you can buy Gypsy Cobs, but that's not worth your money, at least in my opinion. Now, if you ask me which horse is my favorite, you see it on screen right now, the one I'm riding. It's Norfolk Roadster. Why? Because of its looks. And how's that helpful to you? Well, in simple way, the differences between these best horses in the game are so insignificant, it comes down to looks. Believe me, it's like that. To put it simple, you really cannot go wrong with either of these horses. Do you see any difference between this Mustang and Norfolk Roadster? Hardly, I would say. And do you see any difference between those horses you saw before these two? Again, hardly. Take a look at this stolen Morgan. It doesn't look that slow, really. But that's what I'm trying to point out. There is no really too much of a difference between all horses in the game. Yeah, of course those better statistically are better after all. If you want to compare their acceleration and speed and also their stamina and health bars, well, you will see the difference. But people say you need higher health in order to survive more bullets. But in practice, if someone shoots your horse, it will be either critically injured or will die. And it will happen all the same to this Morgan and to the mentioned Gypsy Cob and Breton. They will eventually die and they cannot survive barrage of bullets. So basically having huge health bar can come in handy. But it will not save your horse's life definitely, because when the fight starts and bullets start flying around, at least two will hit your horse and trust me, he will not survive. But if there's one skill you should pay attention to when it comes to horses, I think it's stamina. And it matters the most when you want to ride for a while. On short distances, even the cheapest horses have enough stamina, but if you want to ride, let's say, from Blackwater to Tumbleweed, I don't know why would you ride so much, but if you want to, you will find stamina bar useful. But there is one thing that is equally important as all skills that horses have, and it's saddle. But unfortunately, there is only one saddle that can be considered as the king of all saddles. It's Nacogdoches saddle, or however it's pronounced properly. And Nacogdoches saddle paired with hooded stirrups is a magic combo that gives one more acceleration and maximum speed bar. And if I'm confusing you a bit, when I say one more, it's one more than it was supposed to, because maximum improvement can be up to 2 bars of acceleration and speed. But when you have hooded stirrups paired with Nacogdoches saddle, you will have 3 bars. And if you ask yourself, why did I say unfortunately? Well, take a look at Nacogdoches saddle. It's pretty ugly. It's probably the ugliest saddle in the game. At least in my opinion. I do understand that beauty is in the eye of viewer, but take a look at these skulls. Just who on earth thought that it's a good idea to put such type of skulls on cowboy's saddle? Just compare it with Upland saddle or McKinley saddle. Now these saddles are really looking nice, and there was so much attention to the detail when they created it, so I cannot understand why the best saddle in the game looks so ugly when compared to these saddles, for example, or compared to anything in all honesty, but it's like it is, it cannot be changed. And when you compare stats, you will see why you should stick to the Nacogdoches, however ugly it looks. Now, maybe, just maybe, that one extra bar is not such a big deal after all, but I don't know, I like to have it. But again, these extra stats only matter on long distance rides, and in RDO you will rarely travel so long. So you will probably do just fine with all other premium saddles, like mentioned Upland, McKinley and all other roll saddles in all honesty. And before we skip to the tips and tricks I have for you, there is a few more things regarding saddles I need to tell you. As I already said, you have stirrups and they are important, but all other things like blankets, bedrolls and so on are cosmetics, and they can be pricey, even in gold, so don't waste your money on those things. And there is also one useful service that I prefer to have and some players do not. It's horse insurance. It costs $125, if I recall. And I think it's worth the investment because healing your dead horse costs $4, if I remember correct. So if your horse dies 10 times, it's 40. 20, it's already 80. And 30 times, you already got your money. So it would be wise to have it, at least in my opinion. And there is one more thing that can be useful, especially to beginners, and that's a thing you will be able to buy from Gus McMillan's store now, of course, when you unlock Naturalist Roll. And that's Javelina Tusk, and it's really easy to be crafted. You just need Javelina Tusk and Elliston Carved Bracelet, if I recall, and it costs $500. Now, that's useful when you want to bond with your horse faster. And why is bonding with your horse important? Well, because it improves his stats. Now, 10% might not be such a big deal after all, but if you want to bond faster, it's good to have this task. And another thing when we talk about bonding with your horse, the best and the fastest way is to lead your horse. Rumor has it that you only need about 45 minutes to reach level 4 bonding just by leading your horse. Did I ever do it? Of course not. I wouldn't waste 45 minutes on leading horse around the map, but if you want to and you have time, why not? Usually, since I play around 2 hours a day, I needed about 2 or maybe 3 days of playing time to reach level 4 bonding with my horses. And now, since we covered all the basics and a few more advanced things, I only have to tell you a few tips about tricks for your horses. Of course, there's more than one trick for your horse, but only a couple are useful. And the most useful one is rearing. Take a look how it looks. It is important when you're in the snowy parts of the map and your horse just don't want to sprint. You can stop him, then do the rearing and he will sprint. So I guess this is the most useful trick for your horse. Another thing worth of mentioning is that backward going with your horse. It's simple trick really, just hit control twice fast and your horse will start going backwards. I don't know if that's a very useful trick, but it looks fancy after all. And the third trick many people don't know how to perform is ducking, so hiding behind the side of your horse, let's say it like that. Now, this trick might sound a bit hard to perform, but in all honesty, it is not. All you have to do is to have your gun or rifle in your hands and then aim towards the side opposite of the side you want to lean to or hide to. Now, this trick will make your horse take bullets meant for you, and your horse will die most probably, so you will be forced to continue on foot. So think twice before doing this trick because you will lose your horse, most definitely. And with this being said, I think I've covered everything important regarding horses in RDO. I hope this video was helpful and entertaining to you, so see you in the next one. Bye-bye!